Hey, welcome to Parole Amate. We are at the letter C. My name is Beatrice Basso. I am with ICC and also a theater maker. So the letter C today has to remind me of compleanno, birthday in Italiano, because today, August 3rd, is my child's 9th birthday. So that's what comes. And in thinking about it, compleanno, which is derived from the Spanish. It was borrowed from the Spanish. It has the Latin origin. It's to complete a year. So the emphasis is on finishing a cycle, the completion. You've made it. Whereas in other languages, English, of course, birthday, it's the celebration of, the idea is the celebration of the beginning, the day of your birth. And similarly in French with bon anniversaire, in Japanese, in Finnish, those languages at least, and probably many others in the world, sort of mark the birth. And so a completion for the Italian and the Spanish, again, I wonder if there is a superstitious, perhaps Catholic element there in terms of you know, the term was coined in the 16th century or 17th century, I believe, got established. So the risk of death was much greater and so on. Perhaps there is a little bit of that. And it also reflects in today's habits, which is, I think, a classic difference between US and Italy. In Italy, if it's your birthday, you tend to offer the cake, offer the dinner. In the US, I believe in England too, you tend to be offered things, cake, dinner, and so forth. And perhaps there is something to that etymology in the I completed my year or years, you know, it's I can celebrate, it's an accomplishment. Whereas if you're more like in the place of the one who's birthday, then you can be treated for one day a year as a child. I think they each have their plus and minuses, actually. I want to also remember another way to wish buon compleanno, good birthday in Italian, which is tanti auguri, many wishes. And auguri comes from auguri, which is a combination of avis or avis, bird, and the verb gero or gero, which is to carry out, right? So it was the priests who in ancient times, sort of Italic ancient times, even pre-Roman, would be able to detect from the flight of birds or the interiors of birds the fate or the immediate future of the person who was asking. So, and of course, you know, from auguri, we can get to auspicious and all of that, although I don't know that they have the same etymology. So that, and the final thing I want to say in our 5 minutes of Parole Amate is, and then I'll go back to celebrating my kid, is that, you know, some people love to celebrate their birthday, some people not at all, they want them obliterated. And that reminded me of this book, actually, by Manlio Brusatin, who is an old friend in Asolo, Veneto, who wrote The Art of the Oblivion. And he describes, you know, and I was thinking of the birthday candle, and he associates fire with memory and smoke with oblivion. And I sort of think it's kind of perfect that in the candle of a birthday cake that is summarized with both the memory in the form of fire and then blowing out and hopefully expressing a wish with tanti auguri, that also perhaps embodies the oblivion. So that, another expression I heard my Italian-American partner always say is cento di questi giorni, to wish someone happy birthday, 100 of these days, which I really think is an expression perhaps only appropriate for your actual birthday, right? Because after, maybe it's a little unlikely. Anyway, so this is my wish for all of you to be well. If you have a birthday in August, buon compleanno, and see you next week. See you next week at 5.